what would you say that you've learned the hard way about training foundational models that you wish you knew before you started?
It's very difficult to decide what a good learning curriculum for these models is. That entails multiple things, right? It means like what data do we use during which stages. That's like super tricky to get a good idea about, especially if you want to be efficient and not just train on everything. Some like minor details really, really matter. Like we certainly made our fair share of mistakes early in the process, which I would have loved to avoid. And then also in terms of like hyperparameter tuning, this is like super important for LLMs. The bigger the model, the more sensitive it seems to become in some sense to make sure that you get this right. We've seen with Bloom how this can go wrong. That is certainly something that we were concerned about when we first started training LLMs, but yeah, we managed to get through it and now have pretty reliable setups for our training. So yeah, it's a huge effort, right? This involved a lot of people in the company, both during like the actual physical installation, making sure that we have all the necessary software in place, figuring out how to squeeze like efficiency out of the system, which makes a big difference because it's so expensive, and then also how to build products that support and fully utilize these new models.
Mm-hmm. And you've mentioned that you actually made like, well, a lot of, you know, failures like on a
did
way.
Did I say a lot? I said my fair share, yeah. No, I think we did actually really well. Like considering how new all of this is, how early we have been, I think we were the first commercial deployment in Europe. Of course, the more you know, the easier it becomes to avoid mistakes. Given that we were like in the very first line of people who were trying to get this done. Sure, we made mistakes, like we make mistakes basically every single day. That's part of doing research. But overall, I think we fared really, really well and much better than could reasonably be expected.
Mm-hmm. Is there any like learning from this that you took that you can share?
I mean, the main lesson is you need to make sure that you did your homework. Like, it's very easy to get this wrong, both in terms of how you build, like, equip your actual data center. There are, like, non-trivial things to check in terms of, like, power density, cable runs. Make sure that you buy the hardware that you need, but also don't overspend on things that you will not utilize. Building a supercomputer is not comparable to building to buying a laptop or something. It's much more like building an actual apartment or house. You have to care about the details. Once you have this up and running, the software side of things is like a huge focus area as well. Like, don't underestimate this. I created an HPC team specifically to support our LLM development at the time that we made this transition. That was very, very much worthwhile. Like, they continued to find new ways to improve efficiency, but also add new features to our training and inference pipeline. I think that part is not to be underestimated. And in general, I think it's like the best thing that you can do in order to be successful in AI development, whether or not that's with LLMs or otherwise, is to hire the right set of people.